What is up, everybody? Rod J back again. Time to take a look at another beer. Thank you for swinging by to check out another video. Today I'm going to share with you one that I have picked up a while back when I was up in New Jersey, and this is going to be from Core 3 Brewery. It is a look at their La Femelle Polie, and it is a hazelnut cafe creme porter. So pretty neat artwork on the can here, as you can kind of see. It's kind of got like a, maybe a French or an Italian type look there. But kind of digging that, sitting out in front of the cafe, which is pretty cool for the artwork. And this one comes in with an ABV of 7%. Let's go ahead and get it cracked open and get it into the glass. Not really too many other details on the can, but that artwork is what caught my eye, and that's what made me pick it up. Got a little bit of drippage here from cracking a can open that I did not expect. Now, because of that pour there, it did come out, pour a little bit more of a foamier head than I wanted to get onto this. I'm gonna let it settle for a little bit here, but do have a dark color on the beer, have a deep dark brown head. Aroma wise, you get a nice richness on the nose. Pick up some nice sweetness, pick up the malts. Little bit of a lactose milkish type feel on the nose. But yeah, really the sweetness comes out. A little bit of a caramel undertone on this one as well. But overall, very nice smelling. Taste-wise? Pretty carbonated. I get a nice amount of the carbonation feel. I get a nice settling in the mouth of the maltiness. I'm getting some activity there in the throat area. A little bit of a scratchy type feel there. You have that coffee type bitterness with the porter. You do get a little bit of a roastiness, but it's kind of like a, as you would imagine, a coffee with cream. They were definitely going for something that can give you a little bit of that lightness there, so you do pick that up. But it's got a nice little feel to it. It is lingering a little bit on the duration. Nice medium body here on the beer itself. Good amount of dancing on the tongue there from the prickling of the carbonation. That sweetness, you do pick that up in the cheeks. That does hit you there in the initial stages as well, and then it kind of dies down on the back end. And that hazelnut does come through in this one here. Working into the beer, so that actually comes into play nicely. It's not one that I would say jumps out at me, but as far as being something different and something of a way to enjoy a porter in a more, I would say in a lighter type way, but it's already a lighter type style. I consider it a lighter type style. That's why I usually prefer stouts. But having, I prefer coffee with cream, and I prefer some of the drinks like that. So for me, it's kind of nice having something like that where you have like a coffee and cream type feel. And the hazelnut isn't overly done. It's actually got a nice balance to the beer itself that it sits pretty decently in there. So nice one from Core 3. Again, they are out of New Jersey, Clayton, New Jersey. And I saw on the can here, it did make mention they were actually brewed at Tuckahoe Brewing Company, which I'm not sure if they're more like a gypsy type brewery. I know they're a small brewery in New Jersey, so don't know if they usually revolve around, but it does make mention they're out of Clayton, the stuff that I looked at online. But a nice little job, nice little one I picked up. And if you've had this one, let me know what you thought of it by leaving a comment. But not too bad, not too shabby at all. And again, great artwork. And artwork can bring you in on some of these beers. Seeing some of these labels gets your attention and you end up throwing them in a cart. La Femelle Polie. Thanks for checking out this video. I look forward to catching up with you guys soon. Keep drinking those good beers out there. Remember, there's always time to get your beer on. Drink beer, live hoppily. Cheers, everybody.